Hello. Today I wanted to do something quick and spontaneous. Today I made these toffee crackles, and it's a recipe I've never tried before, and it's a no-bake dish. It's actually very yummy. I'm gonna show you in a second how to make it. And it's nice and crunchy, yet soft and gooey, and I absolutely love this recipe. I'm gonna make it many more times after this. It's very nice to always have a cup of coffee or hot tea, candlelight, and something sweet to warm up your evening on the cold night. So I hope you enjoy this. Alright, so I decided to do this recipe. I've never tried it before. It's called chocolate crackle toffee. And I liked it because it's only 34 calories in one square, which is 1.5 inches. So it's not too bad. For this, you will need a pan covered in foil, and we will spray it with a cooking spray, or you can just butter it up. You will not need to bake it. You'll just need to cool it for 3 hours after you heat up all of these ingredients together. So we're going to need semi-sweet or bittersweet chocolate chips, rice, cereal, light brown sugar, vanilla extract, cooking spray, sweetened condensed milk, unsalted butter, and a little bit of light corn syrup. I got the one that has no high fructose. Okay. So now let's go ahead and mix it all up. Okay, so I pre-measured everything. We need a cup of the chocolate chips. We need 1/2 teaspoon of kosher salt. We need 1/4 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1/4 cup of corn syrup, then 1/2 can of condensed milk, and 1/2 cup of light brown sugar, and 1/2 stick of butter, of unsalted butter. Okay, so we'll start by melting the butter. We're going to add 1/2 cup of light brown sugar. We're going to continuously stir it so it all melts. To pour in 1/2 can of the sweetened condensed milk, which can be eaten just by itself. Just a little bit more. That should be good. Of course, I am just going to mix it up. The heat is medium. If you have a stove like mine, like electric stove, I put it on a setting of 4.5. So it just should be at a medium level. Okay, I'm gonna leave it alone for a little bit, and we're gonna wait for it to combine just a little bit more, and I'll tell you exactly how long it took me after this. Okay. Okay, so it's been about 4 minutes, and it's very thick, as you can see. So that's perfect. I'm going to add half a teaspoon of kosher salt. One-fourth of a teaspoon of vanilla extract. Be careful. Okay. I have to say that the aroma is just so yummy. I think I can eat just this. That's wonderful. And I'm going to turn off the stove. So this time, we're going to put in the cereal. And it's 1 to 1.5 cups of cereal. And again, we're just trying to mix it all in. Now I'm going to transfer it into the pan. You can see I sprayed it. And while the mixture is still very hot, I'm going to just pour it into this form, into the pan. I'm sure you can do shapes with it if you wish. Okay, now I'm going to spread it around. Create a more even layer. Okay. You can do it thicker or less thick, meaning the size. Okay. And once we've done that, while it's still hot, we're going to sprinkle our chocolate chips. Because it's still hot, it's going to melt the chocolate. You can add more or less, whatever you wish. Okay, now we're going to wait for 5 minutes for the chocolate to melt, and we'll look at after.
Sorry, okay.
So now we're going to try to spread it around. You can do it with a spoon or a spatula. Just whatever is more comfortable for you. You really also don't have to necessarily use the chocolate chips. You can just use just crumbled chocolate. Very carefully, like that. Spread it around. Try to do it evenly to cover up the corners here. Yummy, yummy. That looks so good. Okay, and now, do is just let it be. gonna let it stand for 3 hours and we'll be back to take it out and cut it into pieces, okay? Alright. Alright, so it's been a little bit over 3 hours and it's definitely harder than it was on top. So now I'm going to just remove it from the form. Slightly larger than the serving size, which is okay. Okay, and now plant right here. I'm just gonna transfer them, and I'm gonna show you the side. This is great. I think they need to be chilled in a refrigerator. And then they're gonna be just perfect. This is wonderful. I should definitely try it.